edition comes along that kind of just blows my mind a little bit. This time, that honor goes to Rift Ship. This is a platform game with two windows that you can pick up and move about. And basically, anything that appears in one window will also appear in the other. And so, to get your tiny wizard flag, you'll need to place one window in the gap in front of him and use the other window to sample a bit of background with some steps. Now, you've got a route to the exit. It's awfully clever. There are also great puzzles that come from moving the rift over the character, phasing in stuff like doors and pressure buttons before phasing them back out again. And later levels introduce turrets that can be blocked by creative use of the windows. This game is part platformer, part selection tool, shop, and all around amazing. Give it a go. Bunch of puzzlers where boxes join together when you touch them. I count at least five in the top 100. My favourite of the bunch, though, was Sleepy Blocks. This is a game where you control a smiley-faced square in a grid-based world of snoozing friends. If you an adjacent tile, the sleepy cubes wake up and join with you to create a brand new shape. And so, thus begins a bunch of puzzles about carefully picking up new polygons in order to reach the exit. It's about picking the right path and choosing the order. But then, a new mechanic, cracked floor tiles that can turn into deadly pits and must be carefully avoided. But then, there are puzzles where you want to use the pits in order to split your shape. The game has a great understanding of puzzle design and was simply a joy to play. Okay, let me pick one more game about joining together blocks. Because this one is very different. It's called Puzzle Sigma. The idea for this one is to play as a mathematical symbol, starting as a plus sign, and you can attach yourself to big chunky number blocks. If you get a number on the left and right, your body becomes a mathematical equation, and the answer can be used to unlock doors. So pick up a 1 and a 3, and you'll be able to unlock the door marked 4. It's pretty clever and deserves endless points for making a game about maths that's actually enjoyable. Things get real complicated when you start playing with numbers bigger than 9 and multiple symbols and puzzles where you get different answers as you rotate around. And at that point, I started to panic. But if you've got a better nose for numbers than me, I think you'll really enjoy this game. If letters are more your thing, though, check out Factorii. Essentially an entire electronics game made in 48 hours, Factorii is a problem-solving puzzler with one raw material, the letter I, and about 26 different products, the rest of the alphabet. You see, bend, rotate, flip, and combine the letter I using these colourful machines on the right over here, it's possible to spit out any other letter. And so the game is as much about building a production factory as it is about thinking creatively about shapes. Make a G, I guess that's a bent I, a normal I, and a rotated I. Yeah, got it. Can't give it full points of originality. Anyone who's played Space Chem or Opus Magnum will recognise the core concept immediately. But it's done with such alarming proficiency that it really does deserve a nod. We saw a fair few arena battlers in the chat. That's always a smart way to make the most out of the short time limit. One that really worked for me was Coastal. This is, ultimately, a pretty simple game. You control two different ghost-busting pieces at the same time. As long as they're close enough to one another, the deadly laser beam arcs between their guns. Now, anything caught in the middle will be vaporized, leading to a fun, friendly twin-stick arena shooter where you fight ghosts, and a Windows logo. Play it in single-player, and it's a game that will test your coordination. Play it with a friend, and it's a game that will test your relationship. I'd like to have seen a good idea, but it's a great start for a game. Another arena battler I dug was the very innovative Grappling Scarf. One you play as a square with a rather long white scarf, which trails behind you like the body in Snake. Shield to wrap around the base in the middle of the screen and protect it from incoming bullets. But look at the end of the scarf. It's got a hook, which can be used to pick up bombs. Now you can drag them away from your base and hit space to split your scarf in half. Now you can go off and do more work while you wait for the bomb to blow up. Later, however, you'll want to go back to your discarded scarf and pick it back up, because every time you effect of your body, you become shorter and less effective as a shield. It's a but wholly original game where you're having to constantly fire, make small sacrifices for long-term gain, and ebb and flow between bodies that are big. Thank you, Tay. Here's a theme I wasn't expecting in the jam, using a shot to pull bits of the level, rearrange the play space, like the very polished puzzle platformer, Whale Eater. My pick, though, is Phasing Puller. That comes from a very special your powers that happens to change everything. Your hookshot only works when it goes on an object. That's what powers it to latch onto something and drag it back. Otherwise, it doesn't work. This leads to a number of clever and thoughtful levels about moving blocks for jumping on and powered up energy cells for puzzle solving. I also like the minimalist art style. If you've only got 48 hours to make graphics, color palette to create a cohesive style at all. Technology is all about putting things together, whether that's using different dongles to connect up a laptop, chairing multiple Zoom meetings at once, or physically making phone calls using a switchboard. In fact, there were two based games in the top 100, and while I dug the narrative thread throughout Hello Operator, my pick of the pair was Telephone Trouble. The idea wires to make a connection between caller and recipient, but this one's way more manic. You've got five cables to play with, phone pile up like orders in an overcooked restaurant. You'll be frantically checking the phone book to find people's calling codes, and every now and again, someone will need the hospital, and you'll have to drop everything to answer their emergency. A rapid-fire, high-score arcade gem with gorgeous graphics. Give it a play. Another common element in this jam's top 100 was constellations, such as the stunning and relaxing photography gem, Star Snap. But one game just outdid it. It's called Peaceful Evening Among the Stars. It's a puzzle game, connecting up stars to make constellations. You can only drag a certain colorful star, so you'll need to use other smaller stars as steps. Things soon get more complex when different stars are used. Overlapping and circumnavigating other stars. I feel like I've said stars a lot. Anyway, it's just a polished, professional, and eminently playable game. Basically, when I've got to rush through 100 games to get the results out for a bunch of impatient game jammers, well, if I end up playing one game all the way to the end, I think I can safely say I liked it. There's always a pixel art platformer or two in the top 100. This year, one of my favorites was I Got Your Head. Got nothing to do with loot boxes or microtransactions, thankfully. Instead, it's an adorable game about a tiny man and his giant hat. The hat gives you the extra height needed to grab keys, but it also makes you too towering to squeeze through tight gaps. So, soon enough, you'll need to use a low ceiling to knock your hat clean off, turning you to the smaller size. And then, once you've done what you need to do, it's back to the hat. It's a charming game packed with puzzles. Bonus puzzles. I'd be keen to see where the creators could take this with even more fun. Okay, this one we consider the rule that dies. It's called Static Clip. It's a Nitrome-esque platformer where you play as a ball of pulsing energy who always starts on a plug head. Now you've got to make your way to the socket, but you're very lucky in the way you travel. Like, you can stretch out into the world, but only so far together with a power source. If you link to a bulb, though, you can travel through the wires and pop out on the other side. Later, you'll be able to use your...
Welcome, cat! Welcome to the party! Let's go!
Hello?
Click join, get perks, become a team member.
Minutes to spare, I had done. The only thing left to do was put on my masterpiece.
Earth and us hiders had access to the map you see now, the game began. I immediately headed to the safest place I knew, Afghanistan, and took all the guys to the they hide this spot right here. I am Wildcat, that's the right idea. He just went off into the middle of the ocean. He's out of there.